A very good morning to all. Looking at important headlines from the Hindu newspaper for 19th June, on the front page you have Kota MP Om Birla named as NDA's choice for speaker's post. So we had discussed that speaker's elections are due. It was there in yesterday's news. So the speaker's post elections take place in the Lok Sabha. Till that time, a pro tem speaker presides over the sessions of the Lok Sabha. And the speaker's post will be going to the candidate from NDA because NDA has a huge majority in the Lok Sabha. So you can see Kota MP has been named as a choice. So he'll assume office today after being elected by Lok Sabha speakers. This is Mr. Om Birla. Then below you have uptick for India on sanitation and UN report. So India has made great gains in providing basic sanitation facilities for the population. So there have been 650 million people globally who have stopped practicing open defecation between 2000 and 2017, and India accounts for almost 2/3 of the 650 million. So this is there. So a monitoring report by UN organization showed that there has been absolutely no growth in the population with access to piped water facilities over the period. This is in open defecation, steps have been taken, but piped water facility is still a concern. So you can see there's large equality between rural and urban areas in India. So this is a joint monitoring program report by UNICEF and World Health Organization. It shows that India has increased the percentage of its population with access to protected drinking water too. Protected drinking water source should be less than 30 minutes away. It was 79% in 2000, now it has become 93% in 2017. But then piped drinking water is there for only 44% of the population over the 17-year period, and that has remained stagnant. Then here you have Delhi goes looking for giraffe in Thailand zoos. So Delhi Zoo, the National Zoological Park as it is officially known, the zoo director has asked for animal, the giraffe as such, in an exchange program. So from, as you can see, Thailand. So the zoo authorities have written to three zoos in Thailand for the giraffe. So if they can have it through an exchange program. So Delhi had giraffes earlier. The last giraffe at Delhi Zoo was Ankit, who died in 2015. So now it is looking for having the giraffe again in its zoo. Then on page 7 you have UP private varsities to be governed by Umbrella Act. So this is regarding private universities in UP. So Uttar Pradesh government has promulgated this ordinance. It's called UP Private Universities Ordinance 2019. So under this ordinance, now private universities in UP will be required to submit an undertaking that the university will not get involved in anti-national activities of any sort. So they will have to submit such an undertaking. So no such activity would take place in their name or the name of the premises or on the premises in which the university is located. So this is the ordinance. On page 9 you have 4 get life term for Ayodhya attack. So there was a makeshift temple here which was targeted in 2005, and in this terror attack on the makeshift temple at Ram Janmabhoomi Babri Masjid complex in Ayodhya, the case has been heard by a special court, and it has announced a sentence for 4 persons to life imprisonment, and 1 person has been acquitted in this case. Below you have Supreme Court seeks center's view on Hajj private tour operators' plea. So Supreme Court has sought the center's response on the plea by Hajj Private Tour Operators Federation. So they are opposing a fresh condition which has been imposed on private tour operators to charge applicable rates of Hajj Committee of India on additional quota of 10,000 seats allotted to them. So they are protesting against this fixed pricing. And below you have Grey wolf from India killed in Bangladesh. So an Indian grey wolf that was recently killed by farmers in Bangladesh is shown here. So it is believed that the animal crossed over from Indian side to Bangladesh. On the editorial page, the first editorial is preventing violence. So this is regarding a law to protect doctors which has been demanded as such by protesting doctors who have now ended protests. The editorial says that a law to protect doctors is good and a healthcare upgrade is essential. So what is more essential is a healthcare upgrade. And this is organization men. So this talks of JP Nadda's elevation as BJP's working president. So it reveals party's long-term goals. So this is a little political news of no significance for UPSC, but you can go through it. The lead article, an idea whose time may not have come. So this is regarding simultaneous elections. So the debate on simultaneous elections has been initiated. The Prime Minister spoke of one nation, one election. So it says that debate is useful because it could throw up other reforms to cleanse the electoral process. So this is the lead article on how one nation, one election cannot be implemented now. The hurdles as such are discussed too. And this is building confidence bit by bit. So this is regarding India's bilateral investment treaties, BITs. It says that Indian bilateral investment treaties need to strike a balance between foreign investor interests and those of the state. So this is a very important article, bilateral investment treaties, are prominently in news. We have made a model BIT also and are amending investment treaties with various countries on the basis of that. Then on page 12 you have EC issues notices for Rajya Sabha bipolls. So Election Commission has issued notices that separate elections will be held for two seats in the upper house, that is in Rajya Sabha from Gujarat. So Congress has approached the Supreme Court against the conduct of by-elections these to the two Rajya Sabha seats in Gujarat separately. So this is an issue. On page 13 you have India to be most populous by 2027, UN. So this is a report by UN which says that India is expected to have 1.64 billion inhabitants by 2050. And China at that time will have only 1.4 billion. And this is 15 more finance ministry officials get marching orders. So they face allegations of corruption, extortion and bribery. So Union government has sent 15 senior finance ministry officials into compulsory retirement now. So this is another action aimed at cleaning up the government services by the government. And below you have National Crime Records Bureau Center differ on Bengal political murders. So National Crime Records Bureau says that only one such killing has taken place in 2016, but Union Home Ministry says that 36 such killings took place. So this is a data mismatch which is seen here. And below you have Rajasthan extends PM scheme benefit to more farmers. So this is regarding Prime Minister's Kisan Sanman Nidhi Yojana. So Rajasthan government has extended, Congress government in Rajasthan has extended this program to more farmers in Rajasthan. So it had made a promise for loan waiver. So now the Pradhan Mantri Kisan Sanman Nidhi Yojana has been extended to 17 lakh more farmers. So it proposes to give an income support of 6,000 annually to small and marginal farmers with cultivable land holding of up to 2 hectares. So it is done in 3 installments, the total amount of 6,000 transferred annually. So it's an income support scheme. On international page you have US deploys more troops to West Asia. So Pentagon has reiterated its claim that Iran was behind terror attacks, tanker attacks, and Russia and China have called for restraint. And US has deployed more troops in the West Asian region. So tensions are escalating. US said that it would deploy 1,000 more troops to the region. So it is accusing Iran of attacks on tankers in the region. And below you have Libra is Facebook's cryptocurrency. So Facebook is leaping into the world of cryptocurrency with its own digital money designed to let people save, spend or send money as easily as firing off text messages. So this is Libra, which is described as new global currency. So it has been unveiled now. So in a new initiative in payments for the world's biggest social networking site. On business page, you have e-commerce firms take up data localization issue with gold. So e-commerce companies voiced their concern about RBI's data localization norms. They also highlighted the data provisions in draft e-commerce policy. So the draft e-commerce policy also speaks on data localization, and RBI has already given its data diktat. So this was also a question in UPSC prelims 2019. So this is the data localization issue. And there is no news on the last page. So these are the important headlines from the Hindu newspaper for today. For detailed coverage of current affairs, you can visit our website ashr.com. Also, we have a separate course on current affairs, which is a detailed current affairs video course. So you can avail for that too. The details of which are provided here, you can see. You can download PDFs on a daily basis here too at the end of the day. So here you can see is the details of the course too. And sample video provided as well. So that is it. Thank you.